Malaysia's Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin is again facing calls to resign, this time after a rare dressing down from the King. The Sultan has accused the government of misleading Parliament and the people over the handling of COVID-19 emergency regulations. In Parliament this week, the government said that the declaration would be lifted, prompting outrage from opposition MPs who said that there was no debate on the matter. Melissa Goh joins us live from Kuala Lumpur for more on this story. Mel, do these calls for the Prime Minister's resignation pull any weight?
Certainly, pressures are intensifying on Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin to tender his resignation, not just for upsetting the King or going against his wishes, but for misleading the House and confusing the people over the revocation of the emergency declaration and the ordinances. Now, the palace said it's unconstitutional to go ahead to annul it without His Majesty's consent, because just like the King has the right to declare it, he will have to revoke it himself. But the Prime Minister doesn't think so. His office has issued a statement just a while ago defending his action. Mr. Muhyiddin said has acted in accordance to the law and the federal constitution. The King has to follow his advice and annul the emergency. But the King insisted that, you know, it must be laid out in Parliament, the emergency declaration, and debated by all the MPs, which was not done. So the opposition leader, Anwar Ibrahim, has submitted a no-confidence motion against Mr. Muhyiddin, calling for his resignation immediately and to take responsibility of the whole mess, while UMNO leaders as well, including its president Ahmad Zahid Hamidi and former Prime Minister Najib Razak as well, echo similar calls. Let's take a listen.
Barat, if he has any integrity left, he should have resigned, because he has not prepared to face Parliament and not confident of having majority. Now that we have established the fact in Parliament, we leave it to the discretion of the Tuanku Agong to decide what is best to save this country from the present crisis.
Tetapi yang pokoknya tanggungjawabnya tak boleh diletakkan atas bahu yang lain. Dalam bahasa Inggeris, the buck stops with the Prime Minister. Sebab saya tahu banyak perkara zaman saya jadi Perdana Menteri pun saya terpaksa ambil tanggungjawab atas apa yang berlaku.
But having said that, Mr. Najib, the former Prime Minister, is also chairman of backbenchers, said that even though he doesn't think that a motion of confidence will be tabled against Mr. Muhyiddin, because never before a motion is tabled against a sitting Prime Minister, the government said, you know, will decide whether a motion can be tabled or not come Monday when the Parliament resumes its special sitting. Now, meanwhile, Deputy Prime Minister Ismail Sabri said Mr. Muhyiddin still commands a majority support of more than 110 MPs. Well, Anwar insisted that he has the numbers, so I guess we'll never know till a vote is called. It's a 202-seat parliament. There are now 220 MPs, because two have passed away. Now, Mr. Najib himself said that UMNO MPs altogether, 30 of them, will continue to support Perikatan Nasional government, although not the Prime Minister.
And Mel, in regards to that special sitting in Parliament, just hours after the King's statements, that sitting was cut short due to COVID-19.
There were three adjournments even before the sitting was cut short today, when temperature gets really heated, debates were going on. But it was tested that two were found positive of COVID-19 this morning. Now, this has triggered the alarm, the Speaker said, following the advice of the Health Director General, Dr. Nur Hisham, said that all SOPs must be strictly followed. There's no extension of time in the House, and everyone in Parliament must undergo a saliva test before they leave, including the media. We are awaiting our turns, and it's still going on. Now, cases are skyrocketed again. Now, we were told before that the Parliament resits that There were already two MPs that just infected, including six staff members, and scores have been quarantined. They have to be extra careful at this point in time, as cases are still high. Today, more than 17,000 were recorded daily cases, and more than 170 have died. Now, healthcare system continue to remain under tremendous stress, with shortage, acute shortage of manpower, oxygen, you know, as well as ICU beds. Now, all hands need to be on deck. And the King has said that even though the Parliament is sitting, he hopes that all MPs can work towards putting the people first and not squabbles. This is not the time, he said, to continue to engage in political uncertainty.
Mel, thank you very much for that update. Melissa Goh there in Kuala Lumpur.